to tell us a bit more about how they are thinking about their modern data infrastructure on AWS, please welcome Muralidhar Krishna Prasad, EVP Engineering at Salesforce. Thank you, Swami. But before I begin, I would love to congratulate Swami. As you may have heard, he got appointed to the National AI Committee. This is a prestigious committee that advises our president and our nation about AI. So a round of applause. Good morning, everyone. I'm proud here to represent a company that believes business can be the greatest platform for change. Salesforce is not only the sort of the leader in CRM and enterprise software, but also the number one in philanthropy, in culture, and innovation. We pride ourselves not just that we affect over $1 trillion of economic output, but the fact that we affect positively lives of over 4 million individuals. Salesforce supplies Customer 360 CRM software, which puts the customer in the heart of your business, be it marketing, sales, service, commerce, experience, and everything in between. And then we provide all the tools for your data analyst, your BI analyst, and your developers to build rich, engaging applications. But as like you all, when we talk to our customers, one of the common things we have heard in this new digital age is that people demand more personalization. They want the right content, the right channel, the right time. And doing that requires truly understanding what your customer has done with your business. That means bringing data not just from CRM, but from your backend and everything else till you create a single source of truth. But just like every enterprise, this is often very hard because data is siloed across different applications, across different databases, across different business units, right? So really pulling all this together is really a big data problem. And building such a declarative data platform for all these business applications is often hard. Why? Because big data, because you're collecting all these digital signals. So this big data problem tends to have that 5 V's that you would have heard. The first is the variety. You're gonna have data coming from a lot of sources. They're gonna have different schemas. The same customer object is probably gonna have 10 different ways of representing across these applications. You're gonna run into the velocity issue. You're gonna have data streaming in from all your real-time sources from web and mobile, and you're gonna have terabytes of data sitting in batch files that are coming in batch mode. You're gonna run into the veracity issue. The same person, like I probably have 5 zip codes in some of these enterprises. Like, which one do you trust? What's your data lineage? What's your governance policies around it? Of course, as you start collecting more and more data, it's going to be a volume problem as well. You're going to run into terabytes and petabytes very easily. But more importantly, you need to get the value out of that data, right? You want to do your AI and BI analysis on top of it. We believe there is also a sixth V that we should add to this, which is ecosystem value. You want your developers to create new applications. These are not just relational applications. You want to create new applications on this big data. You also want to be able to exchange this data with your partners and build that rich partner ecosystem. And that's why we built Salesforce CDP. Salesforce CDP is a SaaS application integrated with our Lightning platform, Salesforce platform, which allows you to bring in these billions of profiles and hundreds of billions of digital touch points from across your enterprise, whichever application be it, and then create that single source of truth about your customer. It harmonizes your enterprise data and democratizes big data for all your business audience. Now, let's quickly see how this CDP actually works. We first bring in data through a variety of connectors to all these sources, and the data lands in its original schema in these bronze layers. And then we allow either streaming or batch transformations on all this data so that you can transform them into these silver forms. And this data can again be either streaming data or batch data. And then we handle the variety because, like I said before, you're going to have different schemas for all this data. So we handle the variety by allowing you to map them into canonical object models. With this, after this step, you don't care if the customer object came from marketing or sales or something else, it'll look the same. But you still have one issue left, which is you probably are going to have different IDs for that customer across all your digital touchpoints, be it cookies or other IDs in these systems. And so using ML and rule-based techniques, we can then join those IDs to really create that 360 view. Once we do that, you know it's the same person that opened your email or actually had your website clicks or had a service incident or a sales call. All of that, you can actually get that 360 view. Now, with this 360 view, then you can start doing all your AI BI on top of it. But more importantly, you can connect it to all your systems of engagement and record, where your service agent can look at it, your salesperson can look at it. But also, you can send them on journeys, on marketing journeys, or you can send them on ad tech through Facebook, Google, and others. Or just let your data analysts use SQL and other SQL tools to go query those data as well. Now, let's step back and think how we architected this system. This is a traditional big data system, as you can imagine. On the left side, you're going to have all the connectors and the control plane. On the right side, you have all the exhaust of that. And as you can see in the bottom, it's a data store with big traditional big data processing and all our services. And then on the top, it's our Lightning platform that's bringing them together. If you peel back one level, you could see that we use traditional storage techniques, hot, cold stores. We use connectors. We use all the big data technologies like Trino, Airflow, Spark technologies, and of course, coupled with all with the metadata from the Lightning platform. Now, let's step one level back. If you go down even deeper, you would see we use a lot of AWS services to make this happen. Pretty much most of the services that Swami probably described earlier, we leverage them. At the lowest level, of course, S3, DynamoDB, RDS for metadata. We use Data Sync. We use EMR. And of course, all the EKS instances run all our compute as well. If you look at just the data flow, if you look at the data flow architecture, on the top you have the streaming data. We are talking like hundreds of thousands of requests per second per tenant. This is a multi-tenant system. So per tenant, that much data is flowing in. At the bottom, you're going to be getting terabytes of data in batch flows. But all of them is processed and they land in a real-time lake using Iceberg on S3. And on that lake, we're going to be doing a lot of processing, both batch mode, as well as you can see, streaming mode processing on change and delta capture, so we can actually trigger things. At the same time, we also get ad hoc queries and others on top of the lake. And if you see, this is all powered using Spark and Trino services. But EMR is the heart of our system. We did a lot of analysis before we settled on running EMR, because it gave us a high performance with regard to Spark usage. As you know, AWS has its own distro. But performance was not just the only thing. We create and destroy over thousands of clusters. We are able to create clusters on demand based on our workload, based on our customer demands, and give that right SLA to our customers. And critical to all this, given it's big data, cost reduction is paramount. And so we also save a lot using spot instances. But AWS goes beyond that. I think the first thing is the fact that we could automate every one of our dev and production lifecycle. We could spin an entire data center on demand in any country that customer demands. High-scale performance and cost savings are great, but also so is availability and trust. And remember, this data is all our personal data being stored in the system, so security is paramount, and we do use AWS security to do the defense in depth. But above and beyond all that is AWS has been a trusted partner for us, helping us in need and working together as we launch these new services. In closing, business is the greatest platform for change. But for that to happen, you need to have a successful business. And a successful business relies on knowing who your customer is, understanding, analyzing, engaging, and personalizing all that interaction. And to do that, you really need to create that single source of truth powered by data. So go forth, harness all your data, build a successful business, know your customer, and make it that platform for change. Thank you.